In this movie clip, we will show how we can set the renovation views called renovation filters. Let's open the document, Set Renovation Filters, Renovation Filter Options dialog. Below the filter settings, we can see the same three statuses as in the renovation dialog. These are existing elements, elements to be demolished, and new elements. Next to each status, there is a pop-up menu where we can choose from three options. Show option. Elements of this status will be shown using their original attributes and settings. Hide option. Elements of this status will not be shown at all. Override option. Elements of this status will be shown using the override style defined in the Renovation Override Styles dialog box. Let's see quickly the various default renovation filters and discover how we can set them. Let's first select the existing plan filter. Using this filter, all elements having existing or having to be demolished statuses are all displayed with their own settings. All elements assigned to the new element status are hidden. Let's select the demolition plan filter. Here, all existing elements are shown with their own settings. But elements with the status of to be demolished are shown with override display. So you see at a glance what is to be demolished and what is to remain. All the new elements are hidden. If we choose the after demolition filter, we can see the phase when the demolition part has been removed, but the new construction hasn't been started yet. On the new construction filter, existing elements are shown with their default display, while new elements and elements to be demolished are highlighted with their respective attributes. Finally, let's select the planned status. Here, only the demolished elements will not be displayed. In other words, the final project status will be visible. Let's click Cancel to leave the dialog. By setting the renovation filters, we can easily hide, override, or show elements with the various renovation statuses.